Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. How many participants we have? Can you hear me? Samia Iman. Hello. So today we will discuss about the 7 C's of effectiveness, and this will help us to communicate in effective way with others through our for our research work or for our study dealing or business dealing or anything. So we have to improve our 7 C's if we want to be effective in our communication. So every student should have this on his or her fingertips, so he or she can understand these 7 C's well and can incorporate in his or her daily life. So Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I don't know where is other participants. However, we are going to start as we already wait for 1 minute. If there is any distortion in voice or if there is there is stillness in the video or in the slides, please let me know by raising your hands. So what is 7 C's? 7 C's are the lifeblood of communication between sender and receiver. So in our last lecture, we just discussed about sender and receiver, who is sender and who is receiver, and who is source and who is understanding that source or the decoding the message. The sender's message is said to be effective when the receiver understands the same meaning that the sender was intending to persuade his receiver. And if the sender wants to say something else and the decoder or receiver is understanding something else, then it is not good for both of them or for the company, or you can say research project or anything you want to say or you want to pursue. So you have to be very careful about your skills, that what you want to explain, other person should have to understand the same or in the same theme or in the same domain, instead of jumping into another one. So you should be very careful when you are a sender. So you should be very careful to explain it very well, or explain it precisely, and applying all the 7 C's to understand this. Or if you are a decoder, then you also have to be careful and try to understand what the sender want to say. So for any communication, in order to be effective, it must have 7 qualities. These 7 attributes are called 7 C's of effective communication. So these 7 C's are courtesy, correctness, clarity, conciseness, completeness, consideration, and concreteness. So we are going to study all of these one by one and we'll try to understand all of these so we can apply these in our effective communication with others. So at the time of encoding, first of all, we are going to study about correctness. At the time of encoding, if the encoder has comprehensive knowledge about the decoder, about the message of the decoder, it makes the communication an ease. The encoder should know the status, knowledge, and educational background of the decoder. So you should have to know that from which class or from which area or from which school of thought or from which cultural background your decoder belongs. So if you guys or if anyone did not understand or doesn't matter about the educational background or status, or you can say cultural background of the specific person or the decoder, so the message will be in the wrong direction. So correctness is the first point we should have to focus on, that so encoder can understand what you encoder should know on the basics of decoder and the mind state of decoder. And encoder has to understand or to analyze, or you can say to judge, the condition of decoder. So for applying correctness in a good way, encoder should know the right level of language, use the right level of language, not so much difficult language or not so much irrelevant language. Like if you are discussing about scientific literature and you are just using the essay writing words, so it will not be much good in it will be not much good for the decoder to understand. So correct use of grammar, spelling and punctuation, and specifically pronunciation, accuracy in stating facts and figures. Correctness in message helps in building the confidence of the encoder and decoder both. So the most important point in correctness is grammar and facts and figures. Don't fabricate the data, don't fabricate the figures and facts and increase or decrease the knowledge, you know, the accurate knowledge, you know, please deliver that. So comma save lives. This is also an example of correctness. Like we have an example, let's eat grandma. And then we have let's eat comma grandma. So comma save the lives. It, you can understand both the one comma just explain both the statements differently. In actually it's the same statement, however a comma makes it into two different statements. So next one we have in 7Cs is clarity. Clarity demands the use of simple language and easy sentence structure in composing the message. When there is clarity in presenting ideas, it's easy for the receiver or the decoder to grasp the meaning being conveyed by the sender or decoder, encoder, sorry. So your words should be very clear. You should be very clear in your ideas, in your concept, and you have to explain it in a very simple way or a very clear way. If there will be an ambiguity or you just make it complex, maybe the decoder could not understand what you want to say, or maybe a decoder just jump into another domain. So you should be very careful about that, that your words should be very clear, very clean, very straight to the domain. So to apply this clarity, we have to follow the two, we have to choose precise, concrete and familiar words, that are the familiar or easy words for all the community, and construct effective sentences and paragraphs, not so much lengthy paragraphs or so much precise paragraph. Everything should be measured and calculative according to the need of the topic. So clarity makes comprehension easier for the decoder and encoder. So here we have an example. It's like there is a statement that is very much unclear. Being an excellent lawyer, I am sure you can help us. So in clear sentence, it should be like, being an excellent lawyer, you can surely help us. So in the upper sentence, in the first sentence, that is not much unclear, we have some ambiguity. So there will be some other meanings of this sentence. However, in clear sentence, it's very easy and very transparent for understanding. After that, we have conciseness. A concise message saves time of both sender and receiver. If your message is to the point and accurate and precise and concise, then it will be very good for the decoder and encoder. However, if you have a long message about it, you can say that 10 sentences you have, however only 3 or 2 sentences are of you know, some only 2 or 3 sentences have only a logical conclusion, then the other sentences just wasting the time of decoder and encoder, and even the receiver, or you can say decoder, can lose his or her interest. So conciseness is a message can be achieved by avoiding wordy expression and repetition of words or sentences, or the same scenario explaining in repetition. Using brief and to the point sentences, including relevant material, makes the message concise. Achieving conciseness does not mean to lose completeness of message. So you should also have to be very careful when you are going to brief or concise the message. Don't overlook, or you can say don't avoid, the concept of 7Cs of correctness and completeness. You should have to give the complete lesson in a concise way. To omit outdated expressions, please omit outdated expressions. Ask yourself what material is really relevant to the specific domain. look for unnecessary repetition and delete that repetition and words and ideas that is coming again and again in the same concept. So conciseness also saves the time. Here we have the example, if you put extra and irrelevant words, people might get bored and sleep. I hope you guys are not sleeping. So worldly, we hereby wish to let you know that our company is pleased with the confidence you have reposed in us. However concisely you just can say we appreciate your confidence. Same, we have another example, in due course, you can just say soon. Another one from the seven C's is completeness. So your message should be complete. There should be no, you can say, ambiguity or some close open messages, like you just give half information and the other person cannot understand what you want to say in actual. Like you are just saying, I'm going to somewhere. What is somewhere? How you will go there? So this is an incomplete message. By completeness means the message must bear all the necessary information to bring the response you desire. The sender should answer all the questions and with facts and figures, and when desirable, go for extra details. If you need that extra details, otherwise you also have to be focused on conciseness. So provide all necessary information, answer all questions asked by the audience with calm environment. If you don't know any answer, no worries. Just explain it what you know, and you can say that we will discuss it tomorrow or later. We will study and we will discuss. Give something extra when desirable, not always. So you should also have to be focused on your conciseness. Completeness brings the desired response. In examples, we have, please fax me in return the departures from Singapore to Hong Kong on the 8th. So you can see this message missed many things. So what we have missing here, time of the day, airlines flying that route, costs and departure and arrival timings. So with the upper message, you cannot understand much what the other person want to say. How come my request for an interview letter did not receive a response? How much, what we have missing in this statement, we missed the sender name, who sent it, to whom it sent, and all the other necessary information we don't know about that. So your message should be complete. Another point we have here is consideration. Consideration demands to put oneself in a place of receiver while composing a message. It refers to the use of you, attitude, emphasis, positive, pleasant, facts, visualizing reader's problems, desires, emotions, and his responses. So you should have to consider the point of view, the difference of opinion, the respect of your opponent or your colleague or your student or your teacher. If there is a difference in opinion, do not need to shout on him or her or ignore or be egoistic. You just have to consider the facts and figure he or she presenting. And you have to cross verify, and if it's correct, you have to admit it, and if it's wrong, you have to explain him or her with the fine words, not like that you are a hero now. So you have to be very careful about that. After the to overcome all these points, we have to consider these points. See your material from your reader's point of view. Use the word you instead of I and we if you want to give importance or you want to show consideration for your decoder. Readers like to see benefits. Be sure benefits are a prominent part of the message. Conciseness, use positive words. Readers will react more favorably. Consideration means understanding of human nature. So in consideration, to be sincere, you should be very sincere about the data, and also to have to be sincere with your students, teachers, colleagues, or your teamwork or your team, sorry. Unbiased, you don't need to be biased. You don't need to give favoritism, nepotism that mostly we have in our Pakistan departments, and we are very sorry to say that. So we should have to finish this from our lives and from our country. We don't need to be to give favoritism and nepotism to others. Just do everything on merit. to respect others values and opinions, putting your feet in someone else's shoes, and then you can understand what he or she is feeling in this condition. In consideration, when you are not considerate each other, then you can understand from this cartoon what will happen. You will shout on each other, you will hate on each other, and then after that you will tell everyone that how bad he or she is. However, it is just a bad experience. The person is not bad. So try to avoid these types of conditions. After that, we have concreteness. Some students could not join the meeting, so the first link will lead you for this meeting, not the second one. I think they are just using the second link, so please use the first link. Being definite, vivid and specific rather than vague, obscure and general leads to concreteness of the message. Facts and figures being presented in the message should be specific. That is concreteness. So to fulfill this requirement, we have to be very specific about the facts and figures and put action in your words. Choose vivid image building words. Concreteness reinforces confidence. So here we have some examples like vague, general, indefinite, students, GMAT scores are higher. So in this one, we don't know much things. In concrete and precise, we can say in a detail that in 2006, the GMAT scores averaged 600. By 2007, they had risen to 610. So that's the complete concrete sentence. So we have this is the last one, courtesy. Almost everything starts and ends in courtesy. You should have courtesy in your life, in your behavior, in your attitude. Courtesy means not only thinking about receiver, but also valuing his feelings, what he's thinking about now, what he will think with your words. So you should be very calculative and measured with your words. Much can be achieved by using polite words and gestures, being appreciative, thoughtful, tactful, and showing respect to the receiver. Courtesy builds goodwill. This point is very much important. You have to apply this point in every aspect of your life. You should show courtesy for others, respect others, understand others. Don't try to always be egoistic in the manner of others. You should have to give some courtesy to others. Use polite words. Your one smile can help others. So don't try to be rude. Show courtesy. So be sincere, tactful, thoughtful, and appreciative. Use expressions that show respect. Choose non-discriminatory expressions. Like if you have your friend in front of you, your expression is good. And if there is a classmate, you don't like him or her, your expression should not be very bad. It should be the same you have with your friends. So you should be very clear in that manner. Courtesy strengthens the relations of decoder and encoder. So to give respect, using kind words like sorry, thank you, good morning, apologies, and like that, at least one smile. If you are not in good mood, you can give a smile and you can appreciate the efforts of others. So 7 C's, when we apply 7 C's, we save our time and cost. 7 C's help us to convey our message properly to others. It can help us to build a good relationship with others, and it can also help us to eliminate uncertainty. So here we have some examples, tactless, blunt. I rewrote that letter 3 times. The point was not clear. So if you want to write it in a tactful manner, I am sorry, the point was not clear. Here is another variant. So in the first sentence, you are somehow offensive or looking rude. So in the second sentence, it is very good way to express your feelings and expressions that I am sorry, the point was not clear. Here is another variant. So that's we have about 7 C's. So everyone should have to understand this and try to apply in your studies, in your daily life, to be effective in communication. And you should know how to talk with others with a good way for your research project, for your business deals, and for everything. If anyone has any question, please raise your hand. Otherwise, we will end this meeting and we will continue our lecture later. Okay, thank you so much everyone for joining.